Let's walk through the code you wrote to complete the mapper function. First, we create an array, data, which splits each row of data on the comma. If the length of the data array is not equal to 12, which is what we expect given our Aadhaar data, or the first entry is equal to registrar, which would indicate that this is the header row, we continue on to the next row. Otherwise, we print the district and the number of Aadhaar generated, separated by a tab. Now let's talk about the reducer function. Recall that our reducer function will consume the key value pairs emitted by our mapper. So we create an array, data, for every single line, which will essentially be of length 2, containing the key and the value. Note that we split on the tab, which we input into the output of our mapper. If for some reason data is less than or greater than length 2, we continue on. There's something wrong with this key value pair, and we shouldn't process it. Next, we set this key and count equal to the key and number of Aadhaar generated in data. Recall that reducer receives the key value pairs sorted by key. So if this is a new key, let's emit the final key value pair, the key and the total number of Aadhaar generated, separated by a tab. Then, let's set Aadhaar generated equal to 0. Otherwise, let's add the number of Aadhaar generated in this particular key value pair to the total number of Aadhaar generated for this key, and let's continue on to the next value. We include this last if clause for the last key in our data. Because there's no next key after the last key, if we didn't have this, we would not emit a key value pair for the final key in our intermediate data. So here, after we've done all this other processing up here, we just say for the last key, hey, let's make sure that we emit the key value pair.